Hello and welcome to Paula Armstrong Ceramics. So for this video, I thought I'd show you how to make a green man mask, or a green woman mask, whichever one you prefer. I hope you enjoy. Okay, so we're going to start with making the mask, so the face part of the mask. And I'm going to cut this, it's probably a little bit much for what I want. Take a little bit off. And I'm going to do this with a pinch pot. So I'm going to start by turning this into the kind of face shape that I'm after. And then I'm going to do the same as I do my pinch pots, putting it in the palm of my hand and pressing the pad of my thumb in to pinch against the palm of the hand it's resting in. I try not to press against the fingers because that will put the finger marks on the outside, and I'm trying to use the palm so that it keeps the outside reasonably smooth. Gives me less smoothing and work to do later. I'm not worrying about it being too thin because I want some thickness in this to be able to change the form when I press in eye sockets and put the nose in and cheeks and things. So I need a bit of spare clay. Be able to do all of that work when I get there. So. There we go. So I think this is going to be my forehead and this is going to be my chin side. So I'm gonna work on making the face shape. I need to have a think what kind of face shape you want your mask to have. Is it going to have a pointy chin, a square chin, a rounded chin? What kind of expression? All of that kind of thing. Now, I am just going to push this in a little bit so that I get a chin and then press out. This is why I was saying it's nice to have some clay to work with, because now I can press this out and I know I've got enough clay there to do that without it breaking. The surface will crack a bit, but I can just smooth that over. And I can make that the shape that I want. Put the eyes in. Now these are further down than you think, so don't pop eyes up here. We want them down here. And again, I'm just going to press in with the pads of my thumbs, and then I'm going to pinch to give the bridge of the nose there, and then just smooth. And then pinch more of the nose there, take some of this clay down a bit. So for the end of the nose, I'm just going to add a little bit more clay. Now obviously, depending on what size nose you want, you have to put as much clay there as you want. I mean, if you're being quite comical, you might want a really big nose. I tend to just use a ball, make sure it's in place, and then blend into the one I've already pinched first. And then for this end where the nostrils are, I'll first blend one nostril and then the other. So they make, they're at a slight angle and then go down straight at the front. Like that. Make sure everything's blended together so you can't see an edge. So we don't want the nose to look like it's just been stuck on. It's got to look like it's part of the face. I'll then use the end of a paintbrush and I go in at an angle for the nostril and then pull it out slightly. And you can help just shape that back in. When you pull the paintbrush out, you pull it towards the center of the nose, it gives a slightly more natural look to the nostrils. So there we have a nice nose shape. Now I'd like the cheeks to be a little bit more pronounced, so I'm just going to press those up from underneath. This is not necessarily a realistic style, it's a bit more caricature-ish, but I quite like having that shape on my faces. So, and then I press in slightly next to the eye sockets so that it goes out to follow the cheeks. It comes in a little bit at the eyes. Smooth as you go. Okay, so now I'm just going to use the tool to put in the lines that go from the nose to the edge of the cheek. These give me a line to use as a marker for my lips and mouth. So the easiest way I find to do a mouth is actually with my nails, but you can use an edge tool like that, that works as well. But I tend to put my nails in to do the bottom lip to start with. So that I'm drawing in a line for the smile at an angle. So I've got the line in so that you go from the nose that way. And then the bottom lip, I go down and pop the tool in at that kind of angle to make the lips. And then for the top, I do the opposite side. Obviously, I give slightly bigger flowers. flat sections in the middle. And follow the smile. And that gives me my top lip. And then to finish the bottom lip, go in underneath, take off the tool, just round it all off and smooth. You've got a nice smiley mouth. Now, for the eyes, you can do it really simply and just draw a line and then put a circle mark in, and that will give you a very simple eye. Or we can go and make the eye like our eyes are actually made and make an eye socket. So I'm just going to use the end of this tool and very gently press in. To make a couple of holes for the eyes. And then I'm going to make a couple of eyeballs. And get them roughly the same size and the right fit for the holes that you've just made. There we go. And we're going to put a bit of slip in each of the holes and pop one of the eyeballs into each of them. So that we have the beginnings of the eyes. Now I'm going to use the same tool as I used to make the sockets. I've got my hand behind with my fingers supporting, and I'm just going to press in to each of the eyeballs, which helps lock them in place but also gives us the iris shape for each of the eyes. And then we need a slightly smaller circle to press in for the pupils. So we've got the eyes there. Now we're going to give the eyelids. So I tend to just take a piece of clay and pinch. And then trim it so that it looks the shape of an eyelid. Make sure it's not too thick. A little coil, divide it in two, and pop some slip up each of the eyes and across the bottom as well. So it goes all the way around each of the eye sockets. And then we're going to pop the eyelids in place. Around the bottom. So they're all like that. Then we blend them in. And at this point, we can put the line in for each of the eyelids. So you can then do a bit of smoothing and tidying. Obviously the angles that you do, things like the eyelids, will change the expression. Obviously the smile as well. With those things, you can make wrinkles and marks to give different effects as well. I quite like crow's feet because I think they're happy and smiley. With that, there we go. There we've got a face for our mask. So the next thing to do is to make the base that the mask is going to attach to. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is make a slab to use as the background for my mask. Roll it, do the usual flipping in one direction and then flip and roll in the other direction to help with even thickness and tension within the clay. Try and help prevent some of the cracking that can happen with slab. With something that's probably about 5 millimeters thick. It's a bit of a trade-off in terms of the weight that the final piece is going to be and the strength to help when you're building the piece to make it a little bit easier. But you can go a bit thinner if you want, but for me, I think this is a good thickness. So I'm then going to pop my mask somewhere I think would work. And then, actually, I'm going to tear the edges because I think the torn edges will look better. And then me cutting and having nice smooth edges. Mark around the edge where the mouth comes to. I'm going to come in a bit from the top and from each of the sides. And I'm going to cut a hole in the backing. And then at the top of this, I'm going to cut out three triangles. And this will then be how the mask hangs. Now I'm going to pop this on a board so that I can carry on working. Now it's on a board, I'm going to put the mask onto the backing just by doing the scoring and slip. Blend all these edges into the face. Now, you can be as neat or as messy as you want with this. I think for this kind of mask that actually a bit of messy is sometimes a good thing because it looks kind of organic, but it's very much an individual choice. The other thing is a lot of this join will be covered by the leaves and other pieces attached. It should now look like one piece, so that the face is coming out of the backing. Okay. So we now have the base for our mask. And the next step is to make the leaves. And to do this, I'm going to use some of the pieces that I've taken off before. I'm going to roll them out a little bit thinner because they're a bit on the thick side still for the leaves. The leaves are quite thin. And you can make leaves that are actual, like, leaf shapes. Or I quite like just doing kind of teardrop shaped leaves. Like these. If you do different scales and sizes, be very useful. I start with the teardrop shape. And then I use a tool to put the line down the center. And then from that center line, I drag the clay out to the outside edge. Lift it up. You've got a lovely leaf shape. And you can, if you don't like the shape, you can literally just pull the ends off until it's more the size or shape that you wanted. And you can do this with all the different sizes. And it's quite a quick way of doing leaves, I think. Once you get the hang of it. I've made a lot more of the leaves, so the next thing to do is to just get an idea of how I'd like to place them onto the piece. You can put everything in a kind of draft spot if you want, and just go around and put them in where you want them. Or you can just, if you feel confident with it, you can just literally stick them straight into their position. With a bit of slip, pop them into place. Bit of a wiggle and a press just to make sure they stick down. Don't press too hard or you'll lose the leaf pattern on them. And just keep going from there, keep building up. I would start with the big leaves first. And I'm only sticking the base in place so that as things dry, because the leaves are going to dry first, which means they're going to shrink faster than the rest of the piece. So it gives them a bit of space to move if I just stick the bottom of each leaf in place. You want to add a bit of movement to them, so do let them bend and fold and move as you're sticking. Otherwise they won't look awfully lifelike. Obviously, if you don't have enough leaves, you can always add more, make some more and add some more as you're going along. You will need more leaves than you think, generally. Thank you. the leaves that I've made, and actually I quite like that as a surround. I'm not sure I want to go any bigger, so I'm just going to make this smaller so that it fits what I want. The other thing with making it smaller, of course, is it makes it lighter, so it will be much easier to hang. And again, I'm just tearing around the edge because I think I like that edge much more than I would a nice, neat, trimmed edge. I'm leaving the most of the clay so that I don't have too many of the leaves overhanging, because the leaves are so fragile because they're so thin that I think it would be a good idea to have the backing slab there to protect the leaves wherever I can. Is my Greenman mask. Very simple version, and it should hang up from the back. So I hope you like it, and I hope you have fun having a go at your own. You can of course add more than leaves, so if you wanted to add branches or nuts or seeds or whatever else, organic shapes around the mask, that can add some great details in the masks. A traditional Greenman mask also has the leaves coming from the mouth, almost like a mustache. So you could have a look at doing that if you like the look of those as well. It's entirely up to you. Have a play. You can obviously do all different expressions, different ages, and whatever else. It's great fun to have a play and see what you can come up with. I hope you like it, and I hope I'll see you again soon. Bye.